Good morning students, today we are discussing the chapter is 6th chapter decimals. The topic is convert the following into fractions. Let's see the first sum. See this sum 0.28. See how to write this fraction, how to write this decimal as a fraction. In the last class, for suppose 4 by 10. How to write this in decimals? See, take a numerator and see the denominator having 1 0. That's what 1 after you put the point. So 0.4. So in your previous class we have learned this type of sums. That means convert the fractions into decimals. But here we are doing convert the decimals into fractions. So convert this into this. Okay, so the given question is like this. It's look like this 0.4. Here we have 0.28. So that's why you observe the number. What is the number here? We have 28. Don't consider 0 here. Don't consider 0 here. See, just consider 28 as a number. So take that number in the fraction. Take that number in the numerator place and see here. How many digits after? Count right after numbers. Right side numbers 1, 2. Here we have only 2 digits. That's why take these 2 digits as zeros. So, 2 zeros number is, what is the number? 100. 100 having the 2 zeros. So, 28 by 100. 28 by 100. So, understood children? If you have a decimal, convert the decimals into fraction like this. If you have a fraction, convert this fraction as a decimal. How? First take the numerator and see the denominator here. We have 2 zeros. So 2 digits before you put the point. This is the decimal value conversion. So here it asked, convert the following into fraction. So take the decimal numbers and see here which is the number. So write that number in a numerator place. See point after numbers, how many digits are there. So in that digits place you should replace zeros. After you put 1. Understood children? Let's come to the sum. Here you see 4.89. What is this? 4.89. So take this 4.89. Remove the point. Just take 489 by, see here, point after we have 2 digits. So in that 2 digits, if you are replaced with the zeros, it becomes 100. If you are put 1 in the left side, it will get a 100. Okay. In this 2 place you replace zeros and write 1. So that becomes 100. Understood? Let's come to this sum 0.2. Let's take this 0.2. See here, what is the number? Here we have the number is 2 by 0.2, right? So here we have point after we have only 1 digit. So 1 digit 10 having the number is 10. 10 having the number is 10. So 2 by 10. Understood, children? I will tell some more sums. Let's see. See this number 549.38. Let's take the number 549. Okay, don't keep a point. Write 38. Okay, now it comes 54,938 by how many digits we have point after? Here we have 2 digits. So write down the 2 digits and put 1 here. It starts 100. 2 digits having the number is 100. So this is 100. 54,938 by 100. So let's see one more. See here, 87.493. How to convert this number as a fraction? Let's take the number first in the numerator, please. So write this complete number without point. Without point, write a number. 87.493. That means 87,493 by how many digits are there in point after? Here we have 3 digits. So 3 digits, 3 zeros having the number is 1000. So write in the 1000 here. Okay. Now read this fraction 87,493 by 1000. 87,493 by 1000. Understood, children, these sums? 1C. I will tell you. Convert the fraction into decimal. I will tell this one also. See here, how to convert the fraction into decimal. For example, if you have 487 by 10 is equals to how much? How to write as a fraction decimal? See, first take the numerator here. First take the numerator and see how many digits are in the denominator. Here we have only one zero. So, one digit before you put the point. One digit before you put the point. See, 7 before point. So, what is the number it is? 48.7. 48.7. Let's see here one more sum I will tell. See here 597. 597 by 100. So which one you are right in the answer, please? Yes. 597 numerator. Write the numerator 597. And see here we have two zeros, right? So two digits before you put point. Right side, from right side you count the digits 1, 2 before point. Okay. From right side 1, 2. Next point. Understood this one? Let's see here. See, here we have two zeros. Here also we have two zeros. You can cancel these two zeros. Write 404 as the answer. This is one method. And see, I will write it as the decimals. See, write down first. This is R. First write down 400. 40,400. And see, how many zeros we have here? Two zeros. So, two digits before, you put a point. 1, 2. Here, point. So, now the question, you read the answer. 404.00. Point after here, we have two zeros. So, point after, you have zero. So, these two are not a valid numbers. Okay. It's not considered. These two are zeros. Okay. No value is there in zero, right? So the answer is 404. Okay. Understand, children? Once all of you look at your textbook, page number 84. See here, third one, convert the following into fractions. See everyone, here we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 sums are there. So everyone must do these sums. I hope you understand these sums. Okay, that's why same like this you have